This here is an ESP8266. It's a little $3 computer all on one chip with Wi-Fi. That's just insane. The entire modules, this whole thing here, is available for about $3. And up until April 1st, it did not have any way to connect by anything other than Wi-Fi. But I figured out a way to hook it up to Ethernet. So now it can have wired Ethernet instead of wireless Ethernet. And you might be wondering, why would you want to do that, or how even? The how is addressed inside of the Hackaday article that's linked below, or in the video that's, you know, you can click on up there. The why is a little bit, well, to me, very clear, but may not be obvious. Though it has a Wi-Fi chip, and you can connect to Wi-Fi networks with it, sometimes you might want to do something with that Wi-Fi chip other than connect to a network. With 802.11, the Wi-Fi standard that everybody uses, packets are generally flung around from every single device. Any device like my cell phone right here, which is configured in Wi-Fi tether mode, is now telling everybody, hey, I'm Charles's cell phone, I have internet. And Will's AP up there on the ceiling says, hey, I have internet, here's my name. And every device all around says all sorts of information about itself, and anybody can listen, anybody who's tuned to the channel. So that means that even the ESP can hear it. The difference is, now we can get the data off in a meaningful way. So I have the ESP here hooked up and powered by this little power brick thing right here. It's not like hooked up to my computer or anything. And over here, I have a web page. So this is just like the other WebSockets web pages that I've been using. And right now I'm tuned to channel 8, and I can see this looks like my cell phone right there. I can recognize the MAC address. A MAC is a unique identifier for all devices. I can see that the last time it's seen a packet with it is consistently less than a tenth of a second. I can see that the signal coming from it is relatively strong. I mean, after all, my cell phone is right there, and the ESP is right there. Anyway, in this website, I can actually browse that. I could switch the channel back to, say, channel 1. Ah, and I can see all the other channels. I'm actually connected to the ESP through this web page here, through an access point in the ceiling, right there, into this house's internal LAN, out to that switch, and into the ESP. So it's really a convenient way of connecting the ESP to networks, so you don't have to worry about getting them connected to Wi-Fi or anything else if you don't want. Right now, let's just switch back to channel 8. Surely I can get this to go. And as you'll see, since I've switched to channel 8, the amount of time since it's seen all of these other access points and pieces of hardware, many of them I don't recognize, they could be neighbors' devices or anything else, go away. Now, all that I'm left with, mostly, is this one right here, my cell phone. But you might be wondering, how do I know that it's my cell phone? Well, as it turns out, you can actually, with Wireshark, connect to the ESP8266. So the ESP8266's address is 10.1.10.5. Port 6648. Netcat says make a TCP connection to this address on that port and use this symbol, a pipe, to pipe it into Wireshark. When you give Wireshark these parameters, -k space -i space -, it puts Wireshark into a mode where it can just simply capture the packets straight from what we call standard in. So right now, this is just all of the packet captures coming from the ESP8266. So as I can see, there's one packet after another of my cell phone. Let's see if we can find it here. Phone, yes, my cell phone's name is Phone. I know that's original. We can see all of these packets of it saying, hey, I'm here, hey, I'm here, hey, I'm here. And it's really cool that Espressif has given us at least limited access to the Wi-Fi in this way. I say limited because it doesn't give us complete access to all of these packets. Unfortunately, it's it's a little bit limited insofar as the size of the data we can receive. So even though these beacon packets are fairly large, they're 100 or 219 bytes wide, the ESP can only actually capture the first 100 bytes or so of it. So you can see here that, you can see that it has, here's all the data in the packet. These are little messages that are sent on the air. And then unfortunately, right around here somewhere, there, it cuts off and we have to send zeros because I don't know what data is there because it's not being passed to me. At any rate, all of this is now a system by which you can turn any ESP8266, like that one there, into a remote listening station for Wi-Fi signals and plug them into a network and be able to take that data and send it back to a central hub or, you know, whatever else you wanted to view the data on. I could even view it on my cell phone. I hope you guys like this video, and it just goes to show another thing that you can do with the ESP8266 now that it can talk Ethernet. So once again, I'd like to encourage everybody, if they want to understand how this is working, to read the Hackaday article. My GitHub code is posted here, and I hope you guys like it. Who knows, maybe somebody will expand upon this, be able to inject packets with it, or improve the packet API, or I don't know. There's a lot of places this could go, and a lot more of reliability that there could be. You gonna work? You gonna work? Huh? Huh? Let's try, hey, it linked. Okay. There is one big thing I really need to mention about this project. I am still having some link reliability issues. With both products, actually, both the one that's raw and the one that's hooked onto the board. Not really sure what's wrong with them, but I haven't spent that long debugging them. So if it doesn't link at first, you might have to try again. Not really sure why.